Palestine can be at the forefront of this effort. The Palestinian economy is part of the Arab economy, and I'd like to repeat this. The Palestinian economy is part of the Arab economy. We look to our neighbors, Egypt, Jordan, and to the GCC as our natural trading partners. It is there where our high tech and know-how and human capital can properly express themselves. We also lie on the Mediterranean with easy access to Europe and Africa. We are truly at the crossroad of civilizations. We are a portal to the world, to the region, and from the heart of the region. Ours is among the best educated populace in the world, let alone the region. Palestinians have one of the highest, if not the highest, actually, rate of PhD holders per capita in the world. Illiteracy rate is near zero. And by the way, this is not arbitrary, it's not a coincidence. This is our approach. It is a long, long-term investment, and it can be summarized in three words: education, education, education. And our youth are innovative. Indeed, the ABCC has hosted only 2 weeks ago 9 Palestinian startups, entrepreneurs who have developed great projects in the fields of logistics, tourism, artificial intelligence, blockchain, sustainable living, smart government, and smart retail, to mention only a few. By the way, some of them are outside in the booth under the motto, Palestine is open for business. Please go and meet them later today. Our agricultural sector is large and productive. It contributes 7% to our GDP and employs 12% of our workforce. Our ICT workforce is second to none. The sector contributes 7% to our GDP, and the workforce is highly skilled, whether in software or hardware development, and the IT services or development arenas are now booming as we speak. Then there is the tourism, and only 2 years ago, Palestine was visited by 2.5 million tourists, and our tourist services, hotels, historic sites, some of them dating 3,000 years back, appeal to all kinds of tourists and pilgrims from around the world. Palestine has natural resources waiting to be exploited, from minerals in the Dead Sea to gas only outside the shores of Gaza. And we have great growth potential when it comes to regional integration. With Arab-Arab integration already, the Palestinians are spread across the region, as you know, having helped build the economies of the Gulf and the North Africa, providing also a ready, available network for trade. Of course, there are barriers for our development. And there is no greater barrier than the political barrier we face. We appreciate all the sincere efforts to help us become more prosperous. Of course, we want to be more prosperous. But ultimately, the Palestinian economy does not suffer a lack of resources. The foundation for a successful economy is there. In our people, it is there in our people. It is there in our resources. It is there in our geographic, strategic location. The pillars of a great trading nation and a crucial portal between the Arab world, Europe, Asia, and Africa are in place, ready to be utilized. The greatest barrier to our prosperity, our economic prosperity, remains as it has been for 70 years. The physical barrier to trade, the lack of control over our borders, our resources, our economic transactions, the lack of political and economic sovereignty. I was told to keep the political discussion aside, so I will conclude by saying that for 27 years, many has been trying to put the economic cart before the political horse. Let us end this. Let us harness that political horse. Let us focus on resolving the political issues. Let us really provide the chance to end this disassociating prosperity from peace. If you disassociate prosperity for peace, you neither achieve peace nor you achieve prosperity. And this is why this conference for us, the Palestinians, for all of us gathering in this room was a great day, a great opportunity. Thank you very much for listening, and thank you for organizing.